Hello, my dear sewing friends, and yes, we're talking about stocking stuffers again. But the question is, are we gonna be sewing them? And that remains to be determined. And I must admit, I truly love holiday season. It's one of my favorite times of the year, and I absolutely love to give gifts. That's one of the reasons why you see so many videos about gifts from me. And that kind of got passed down to me from my mom. She is a gifter. So I got that from her, and now I'm trying to pass that joy on to you. So much so that I even created a free template for you guys, so that way you could also replicate this without a problem. So without any further ado, let's jump right into it. And yes, Skillshare is sponsor of today's video. A little bit more about them a little bit later, but right now let's jump into this first one. This first stocking stuffer idea I've been actually doing for years, and I'm really happy to share it. It comes with two pages of free templates. The first page that you see me cut horizontally is actually for the greeting card itself, and it's not just any greeting card, and you will see why. The second contains banners and simple shapes that you can then decorate. You will see gray lines on your greeting card template. Now go ahead and fold it in half, and you want to make sure that those gray lines are on the back of your greeting card. Now you will need to cut those gray lines. So take your scissors and cut exactly where those lines are at. Now this is particularly for Burt's Bees chapstick. Now not all chapsticks are created equally, meaning that some of them are taller, some of them are shorter. So if you're using any other chapsticks, you will need to adjust the template or make your own. It's really easy. Now pull three of the cuts like so, and it's time to decorate. Here I'm using just the inside roll of the wrapping paper that I have. So really, use what you have and you'll be able to create beautiful things. I have cut these in the shape of little rectangles, so that way they would fit in the middle of my greeting cards. We want to make sure that nothing goes over the cut area over here. So now I have glued them on all of the three of my greeting cards, and here I have some random star stamps that I've rescued from a trash can from my previous job. So I thought, you know what, let's put them to use. I'm using sticky notes, which just happens to fit perfectly over the brown area, and now I'm going to be stamping with some archival ink on top of my greeting card just to create a really fun background, since I'm just really using white cardstock that I have at home, and I don't have any other specific, you know, scrapbooking cardstock or anything like that. If you do, of course you don't have to do this step, just use what you have again and make fun and make do with what you have at home. Now, this is how it looks when it's done. I'm gonna remove the sticky notes, and I think it looks really fun. I'm gonna go ahead and repeat it all three. Now we're really gonna get into the most exciting part. We are getting into the major decorating. Here I have three little snowmen that I actually cut on my Cricut for a completely different project that didn't work out. So I thought, let me use them here. I've colored them with my colored pencils. So cute, aren't they? Snowmen are a little fiddly to cut just by hand if you don't have Cricut. And by the way, all links will be in the info box below. So I did prepare some really simple shapes for you on that template that is available for you for this project. And those simple shapes are a star, a Christmas tree, a gingerbread man, and a circle. So you can use those to decorate your beautiful stocking stuffers. Now I've glued all of my snowmen on, and it's time to glue on the banners. Now I decided I'm gonna glue two of the banners on a purple and on a pink snowman, but for the teal snowman, I'm gonna wait a little bit. I'm gonna see what kind of sentiment I want to put on it. To glue the banners, I'm using little puffy dots, but you don't have to. You can just use regular glue and glue them flat. Again, use what you have. Now grab a hole punch, and I didn't have a regular paper hole punch, so I'm using a leather hole punch right over here. You want to punch holes right in the middle on the very edge of the opening of the greeting card. So you want to leave just enough space so it's not too close to the edge, but you also don't want it to be too far in the greeting card. So let's go ahead and do that. Once that is done, go ahead and grab the chapstick. And as I mentioned, I'm using Burt's Bees for this particular stocking stuffer, and that's what the template is for. And I like to buy these little assorted ones, so that way we can make a couple of greeting cards and a couple of stocking stuffers right away. Go ahead and pop up three of the flaps. And now we're gonna insert the chapstick. The chapstick is gonna go in the two middle flaps or two middle cuts that we have made. And the very very top and the very bottom flap are smaller, so the chapstick is not gonna go through them, but they're there in order to keep the chapstick from sliding out of the greeting card as you move the greeting card around. Now you can go ahead and grab a little baker's twine or a little ribbon or anything else that you have, a little piece of yarn maybe, and go ahead and tie these beautiful little ribbons. Of course, first you will need to write wishes inside of the greeting card and then you will need to tie them. However, you know, just for the purpose of this video, I'm gonna go ahead and tie them right away. And as you can see, none of the chapsticks will fall out of your stocking stuffers. I truly think that a little sparkle makes everything a little bit better. So I have this tube of glitter glue that I got from Dollar Store a couple of years ago. And hey, I use it quite a bit and I still have some in the tube. So let's just go ahead and jazz this up with a little bit of sparkle, with a little bit of glitter. So that's what you see me do right on your screens. And that's it. You can make these for Valentine's Day. You can make these as little simple gestures of kindness. You can make these for birthdays. You can also make these with kids because this is such an easy peasy project, yet it's so nice and it's also something that somebody would really love to use as well. So it's 2-in-1, a greeting card and a chapstick, and it makes a perfect little stocking stuffer. Tell me, wasn't that easy? I think it was pretty easy, pretty quick, and also creates a beautiful little stocking stuffer for a variety of occasions, or maybe just a gift for a random act of kindness. Something that you would give to somebody as a thank you, but it does not make them feel obligated to give something back to you. Something small, something beautiful, something to say thank you. This second idea I've been also making for quite some time, and I absolutely love it because not only it creates a really cool, tasty, delicious treat, but also it looks really good on your Christmas tree. So the dimensions of your little pouch or holder or pocket or delicious ornament, however you want to call it, are going to depend on what you want to put inside. So for me, that's the hot cocoa pouch. And as you can see, I folded my piece of paper, which is just a regular piece of printer paper, in threes. So I created like a trifold pamphlet. I want to make sure that I leave about an inch from the bottom and a little bit on the sides as well, because our pouch is not flat. So we want to make sure that when we actually put this all together and either glue it or sew it. Yes, you heard that right. We might sew these. So when you put this all together, you want to make sure that your pouch will be actually able to go inside, because the pouch is not the only thing that's gonna go inside of these little treats. Now, in order for this to look really nice on our Christmas tree, I want to cut the front flaps of this little pouch on an angle. So here you see goes the first one. And now we're gonna do exactly the same thing with the other side as well. It doesn't have to be centered and can be a little bit off, just like you see me do on a screen. So whichever way you prefer. Now what we want to make sure that everything definitely fits as intended. And I really want to round the corners as well. I think that round corners kind of add a little special touch. So the template is ready. Now let's go ahead and grab the cardstock. I'm working with white cardstock, but you can work with any patterned or any fun print cardstock. That's even better, since that will definitely look really nice. Here, all I'm doing is I'm just transferring all the markings on the cardstock and cutting it out. I'm gonna make 3 at the same time. You can make more, or you can make 1 to first to practice and see how it goes. Hear how these all look when they're folded. Now what we want to do is we want to sew this side and the bottom. And yes, you heard that right, we're gonna sew it. You can of course glue it as well or staple it, but I do prefer a really nice stitch on those edges. I actually usually use a contrasting thread, like a bright red or really nice winter green. This time I'm just gonna go for a white thread, but of course, as I said, if you use contrasting thread, it just looks so much nicer. So here I have sewn all three of these, and do not backstitch when you do this. Instead, tie the loose threads in the knot. That will be so much better for this particular project. Now, when you're stitching cardstock, please make sure that you use old needle that you no longer need to use for any other fabric projects, and preferably that needle should be medium or large size, since cardstock can be a little rough to go through. And also make your stitch length a little bit bigger, that will also help you out. Now, since I'm using white cardstock, I decided to go for exactly the same trick as we did in a previous DIY, which is, yes, to stamp some really fun stars. Now, I've decided that each of the pockets is gonna get one hot cocoa pouch, but it doesn't have to be hot cocoa, it can be apple cider. By the way, Hershey's bar goes in there really nice as well, so it really depends on you. I've also included one chocolate, but then I decided let's go for two. By the way, quick tip, any candy or chocolate with really nice bright wrapper is gonna look really good on your Christmas tree when you hang these. And in order to do that, go ahead and punch two holes at the very top of our delicious little Christmas pocket, and then insert a ribbon or a baker's twine or whatever you have available. That will make it a little bit easier for us to put it on the Christmas tree. Now, the space on top is perfect for inserting a name or a sentiment, whichever you prefer. Now, of course, as I mentioned before, a little sparkle or a little glitter makes everything better. So I've decided to do exactly the same thing as we did in the previous DIY. Now, here's a quick little tip. If you put these on a Christmas tree and you have a lot of kids around on the holidays, letting them find their own little pouch might be a really cool Christmas Eve or Christmas Day activity. Much as I love working with fabric, sewing, and anything sewing and dressmaking related, it really is fun to work with other mediums as well, especially with materials like cardstock, because it does act completely different, right? It holds to shape. It is completely different material than fabric, but it is fun to change it up a little bit from time to time. So let me tell you a little bit about Skillshare, who is today's sponsor. As you guys know, I've been a member of Skillshare way before we started working together, and I absolutely love the platform because it really is all about learning, and this is a perfect place where to explore new passions. So, what is Skillshare? It is an online learning community full of thousands of classes on different topics. And since today we're talking about paper medium or cardstock, you can find their classes on art and illustration and all sorts of paper related stuff that you will absolutely love. And for 1,000 first subscribers to click on the link in the info box below, we have a special offer today. You get 1 month of free premium Skillshare membership. So definitely try it out, because I found a really cool class for you that I think you will enjoy. And the class is by Emily Paluska. She is a botanical paper artist. Can you imagine? So the class is about paper crafting flowers, beautiful lifelike florals that anyone can make. She's making them out of paper, and they are amazing. Classes are well structured, there's no ads, everything is about learning, so it really is a very good platform where to explore some new creative avenues. So even if card making or stocking stuffer making is not your cup of tea, definitely check it out just for visual purposes, because that class is just wow. So definitely take a look, click on the link in the info box below to get your free trial, and I hope that you enjoy. Now for this project, I did use my Cricut machine, but please do not feel discouraged. Cricut definitely helps and makes it very easy to make these beautiful things. But once I open the design file, you will see how easy it is to do by hand as well. So we're after this decorative tassel gift box. Let's go ahead and open up. And I do like how it looks off the bat, but we're gonna customize it a little bit. And all we're gonna do is we're gonna remove these tassels because I don't wanna make them after the box. So that's what I really want. And let's go ahead and cut it on the Cricut. Now, this is just a simple cardstock that I had for a while, and it's not even Christmas themed. So I just picked the ones that are more neutral, like black, whites, grays, and this kind of pinkish reddish one. Now, Cricut does make it easy. It did score the lines where I need to fold my boxes. So here I'm doing exactly that. I'm gonna fold along all of the lines that the machine did score. Now, if you're doing this by hand, which is, I promise you, it's not that difficult. I've done these boxes before by hand as well. If I were you, I would not go for intricate details. I would go for a simpler design, but it's pretty easy to make one. You can also use any of the boxes that you have at home as a template, just to kind of peek and see how the box is actually constructed. So I'm folding all of the boxes that I cut with Cricut, and the next step for us is to glue them together. And there's only one spot where you have to glue, so it also makes it very easy. So let's go ahead and get that done. And you know, now that I'm thinking about it, you might be able to find some similar, simpler boxes at dollar store, pick those up and then decorate them. That could also be an option for you as well. So now that we have glued these together, let's decorate. I'm after the snowflake table runner because I really like the shape of that snowflake. So let's go ahead and customize the file because it's way too big for what I need. I have a tiny bit of glitter vinyl. So what I want is I want to use it as a sticker of sorts. All I'm doing here is I'm making snowflakes smaller, and I also want to cut quite a few of them at the same time because I have four boxes to decorate. So let's go ahead and get that done. Once you have glued all of your boxes, all we have to do to really finish assembling them is to close the bottom. And you know what? I didn't really like how flimsy it was at the bottom, so I did add a little sticker that connected the bottom to the actual base of the box. The sticker, it was just like a little label that says made with love that I had from Farmer's Market. So it's optional. You can also use just a scotch tape. And that's how the box looks when it's all put together. So let's go ahead and finish all of the boxes so that way we can decorate them the way we want. And here comes the glitter vinyl, and I truly think that it really transforms this very regular black and white striped cardstock into a holiday themed box. Now, one of the reasons why I really love this particular shape of a snowflake is because you can also use the negative spaces that were left after cutting it out, and I decided to use those little diamonds as a decorative element as well. So it's always a win-win because you guys know I'm a little frugal. I like when I use the most of my materials, so this definitely is right up my alley. So go ahead and decorate all of the boxes, and then let's go ahead and fill them up. Now, creating these little boxes did make me feel a little homesick. Now, originally I'm from Latvia and my hometown is Riga, and if any Latvians are watching, they seem sveiki. Now, in Latvia and Riga around Christmas time, it's very, very common to see little boxes in the shapes of houses being sold in the supermarket as little candy treat for Christmas, and they're filled with all sorts of different candy, and I used to receive them as a kid for Christmas all the time, so it definitely reminds me of my childhood and of my hometown. So sweet, sweet memory. So here I'm just filling these little boxes with candy. The Hershey bar fits in there perfectly, but you need to make sure that it stays in the middle. So you see, I'm trying to position it in the middle, and then you just close it and that's it. You have a perfect little stocking stuffer or maybe a treat when you go to visit somebody during holiday time. I truly think that this is such a sweet little gesture that everybody will love. My dear sewing friends, thank you so much for watching. If you want more stocking stuffer ideas, I have a full video that you see on your screens right now. And until next time, happy sewing, happy crafting, make something beautiful for yourself, for others, to brighten your day. And I'll see you very, very soon in another video. Bye!